Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Wireshark to analyze HTTP traffic and get useful information from HTTP header. I will start with Wireshark in Windows environment. Now this machine is connected by an Ethernet card. In your case, check out which network card is showing activities. So I click on the network card and then the packet capturing starts. We'll stop this capturing. Before doing any other activities, I will clear the cache of my browser. Now I want to get into detail of HTTP request response. So I look at HTTP packets only, filter with HTTP, and then I will start a new capture. So I click on the start capturing packet button and continue without saving previously captured packets. And then I will open a link. So this link has been open and I will stop this capture. You can see there is a head request first and then a response. Then there is a get request, which is the request to open the file. And then this is a response, another get request and another response. Now, if you look at the first GET request, expand the HTTP protocol detail, then you can see the HTTP version here. This request is going from my computer, which has a private IP address 192.168, and going towards the internet, which has a public IP address 128.119, and so on. If I check my computer's IP address, go to the command prompt and type in ipconfig. And now if you look at the Ethernet adapter that I'm using here, Ethernet adapter, its IP address is 192.168.0.116. And this is the 192.168.0.116. This IP is the source. That means this data packet is going from this computer towards this computer, which is the server on the internet. And the request is get, and this is the file name. So this computer is saying get this file from this server. The next data packet source IP address is the same IP address as the server that we saw before. So this is the source. That means it's coming from the internet towards my IP address. That means to my computer. So this was a response from the server. The next packet, again, the source is my computer and the destination is IP on the internet, and definitely it's a get request to get this file. And then the next packet is showing the source IP address as an IP address from the internet, and the destination is the IP address of my computer. Now if we look at the first get request, that HTTP version and the file that is being requested. If you look at the response from the server and go into detail, then you can see the HTTP version 1.1 and expand the response code is here. The response phrase is here. And then this file has been requested, the request URI, and then this is the size of the file. Now this header I expanded is the HTTP header only. There are other headers as well, such as here you can see transport control protocol, which is TCP, and you have the detailed information of that header. There is IP header, there is Ethernet header, and so on. Next, I'm gonna do a different type of capture. So first I will clear the cache of the browser, then I will start a new capture with HTTP filtered. And then open a new URL. There's a different content. Next, I'm gonna refresh this page or request the same URL again. So I refreshed and then I stop capturing. Now you can see this is a different file request than the previous one. Now let's look at the HTTP GET. As you can see, there are 1 and 2 GET requests. The first one is when I opened this URL, and the second one is when I refreshed this window. That means I am requesting the file again. So take a look at the first one. Here, HTTP GET, the requested file, HTTP version, and then other information. Next, take a look at the second GET request. The content is very similar to the first request, but on the second GET request, here you have something extra, which says if modified since. If you look at the first GET request, there is no such content. The second request has if modified since. No if modified since, right? So what happened is this second GET request is being sent and is saying, send me the file if the file has been modified after this time, because this browser has already got this file, and then I refreshed and then it's sending the request again and saying if the file has been modified, then send it back please. If the file has not been modified, then you don't need to send it back because I already got the file. Also, if you look at the response for the first GET request and the second GET request, first GET request response was 200 OK, and the second GET request response was 304, which means not modified. So the second GET request essentially said, if you modified the file after I got the file, then send it again, and the response for the second GET request was file not modified, and as a result the content was not sent. You see request URI, and then there's nothing after that, but the first one says request URI and then file data is 371 byte sent to this machine. Okay, next I'm gonna get another file from the server. So first I will clear the cache and then restart a new session and then open the link or open a file request and then stop capturing. Okay, if you look into the detail of the captured packet, even though I didn't refresh the browser screen, you see that the multiple GET requests have been sent from the browser. The responses came as TCP segment. The content came in multiple TCP segments. And each of these segments has some sequence number, acknowledgement number. So these numbers are used in TCP protocol for reliable and error-free transfer. Next, I'm going to send another request and capture data packets for that request. So I will clear the cache first. Then I will restart Wireshark capture. And then send a request by clicking on a link. So this link has not only the text content but also the images. One is here and another is here. I'll stop capturing. Now if I look at the captured packets, I can see there's a GET request for the HTML file itself. There is another GET request for Pearson.png, which is this image file. And then another is for cover 5th edition JPG file, which is this image file. So you can see their GET request for each file, the HTML file itself and two image files. Now if you look into the two GET requests for two different images, if the source is my local computer, destination is 128.119.245.12, and this is the other GET request with the same destination IP address. Now if you look at the timing of these two requests for the two images, packet number 298 for the first GET request for PNG image and packet number 308, the time for the first request is 10.154794. 206763 is the time when this response came, and then 234540 is the time when this request went out. So the timing sequence says request went out, response came back, request went out, and response came back. So it looks like a sequential. In your case, observe the time. If you see that this first request response came after the second request was sent, that means they are not in sequence, they're being processed in parallel. Now I'm going to capture another HTTP request with authentication. So I will clear the cache and restart the capture, and then open the URL with an authentication request. I did capture a few packets and it's looking for a username and password. Type in the username as Wireshark_students and the password is network. Then press OK. Now let's take a look at the requests. There is one GET request and another GET request. The first GET request was to open the web page itself. And the second GET request is the one after I type in username and password. If we look at the response of the first GET request, this is the response packet. So let's take a look at the response. The status code is 401, which means unauthorized. So because I needed a username and password, so the response initially came as unauthorized and prompted for username and password. Now if you look at the second HTTP GET request, then you would see some additional information. This new field has been added to the second GET request. Alright, the response, because the username and password was not really the correct username and password, so the response for the second one is also unauthorized. In summary, we used HTTP GET request in different ways, starting from very simple file request to larger file request, file with embedded content such as image, and request to the pages that needed authorization. We looked into the packet details and looked at different requests and response inside the packets. And that is the end of this video. I hope you found this video was helpful. If you would like to receive notifications on future videos, please make sure you are subscribed to my channel and set up notifications by tapping on the bell. Thank you for watching.